Lovel, he stood at his castle gate, combing his milk-white steed. When along came Lady Nancy Bell, wishing her lover good speed, wishing her lover good speed. Oh, where are you going, Lord Lovel, she said. Oh, where are you going, said she. I'm going, my dear Lady Nancy Bell, strange countries for to see, 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 strange countries for to see. When will you be back, Lord Lovel, she said. When will you be back, said she. In a year or two or three at the most, I'll return to my Lady Nancy, see, see, I'll return to my Lady Nancy. And he had not been gone but a year and a day, strange countries for to see. When languishing thoughts came into his mind, Lady Nancy Bell he would see, 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 Lady Nancy Bell he would see. Well, he rode and he rode on his milk-white steed till he reached fair London town. There he heard St. Barney's bell, and the people all mourning around, around, and the people all mourning around. Is anyone dead, Lord Lovel, he said. Is anyone dead, said he. Well, the lady's dead, the people all said, and they called her Lady Nancy, see, see, they called her Lady Nancy. The grave to be opened forthwith, the shroud to be folded down. Then he kissed her clay-cold lips till the tears came trickling down, 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 down. Tears came trickling down. Lord Lovel, he died tomorrow. Lady Nancy, she died of pure, pure grief. Lord Lovel, he died of sorrow. Lord Lovel, he died of sorrow. Lady Nancy was laid in St. Clement's churchyard. Lord Lovel buried close by her. Out of her bosom there grew a red rose. Out of his backbone a briar, a briar, and out of his backbone a briar. Where they grew and they grew on the old church tower till they couldn't grow up any higher. There they tied in a true lover's knot for all true lovers to admire, admire, for all true lovers to admire.